Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Caleb Durward, and I have a spicy one here for you this week. This is a brew by a Mr. Shane McDermott, and he has been crushing Moto with this thing. He has just been racking up QPs over QPs, and I've been lucky enough to see the deck as it's been evolving, both because people have been writing about it, but also because people that work with Shane have been messaging me lists nonstop, and the deck's really interesting. And it's powerful. It's like incredibly powerful. If you ever play a Swans and then scred it and just get to draw five cards for one red mana, you feel like a god. And then by the time you're at that point where you're drawing so many cards, you have a bunch of like these sleek, efficient counter spells to protect the Swans. So there's not really anything your opponent can do to dig themselves out of the hole. The first scred is going to find you more screds or snapcasters to rebuy the screds. And you're just going to have your whole deck. You're going to have way more resources than the opponent. Meanwhile, these cheap, sleek, efficient burn spells also are really good at slowing down the game so that you actually get to the point where you can play a Swans and untap with it. And untapping with a Swans is better than untapping with a Jace. I won't tell you which Jace, but you can get the idea. This is one of the later builds. They added Soulfire Grandmaster pretty recently, which has been pretty miss for me on the hit or miss scale. But that I also haven't played against Burn, so it's just been this, like, 2-drop that's gained me some life in some situations, but hasn't actually ran away with a game. I have rebought some Screds, and that feels pretty good, but I don't know if it's quite worth the slots. Dragonlord Ojutai has been a recent addition. Basically, when you're playing this deck, if you don't have a Swans, your deck doesn't do anything. You're sitting there with a pile of bolts. And so Ojutai is kind of the Swans number 5, this card that can come down after you've bought all this time and run away with the game, like run away with just a pile of card value. Anyway, so it's kind of similar, and it can also help you find the Swans. I think they might be up to 2 copies right now, but I'm not. it's I've had it terminated a couple of times, and it is a little bit clunkier than Swans and a little bit less powerful, believe it or not. Perfectly fine finisher, but I'm not sure what I want to cut to fit in a second one. Maybe the Soulfire Grandmasters can move to the sideboard. I'm not sure. Something that I did add was Vendilion Click, and I've been really happy with this card so far. It serves the same function here that it does in Twin, where it kind of sees if the coast is clear and helps you resolve your Swans, and then it also pressures the opponent when you don't have a Swans, so it's performing multiple roles in the deck. And then cantripping away cards, like some matchups, Lightning Bolt is just an embarrassing Magic the Gathering card, and being able to cantrip dead cards away is really nice as well. So I've been happy with the Click. I'm probably going to add a second one. What else? What else is there to say? Oh, it's interesting to play Scred in a deck with 3 colors, because usually I've only seen it in the mono-red Boros Reckoner, like Blood Moon deck in Modern, but this deck gets away with it just by playing so many fetch lands and by being base blue. Like, we actually don't need very many red or white sources, but there's a couple in here. And by keeping the mana base almost purely basics, by using the fetch lands for fixing, it allows us to play Blood Moons out of the board, which is really nice. There's some matchups that we would otherwise be weak to that we can just hose them with Blood Moon, and that's kind of cool. So yeah, I'm not sure if the white splash is needed, but it does give us a lot of awesome sideboard options, and it also does shore up the burn matchup. And it gives us access to Dragonlord Ojutai, and Ojutai is sweet. The standard staple, beating down people in Modern. Yeah. Well, with no further ado, I would like to show you guys how this deck plays out, because when it works, it's awesome. So yeah, I'll see you guys in round one. Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to round one on the play, keeping this hand. All good things. Just gonna run the steam vents out tapped. Sand needs a Swans, man. Sand needs a Swans so bad, they all need Swans. Okay. Alright. Bolt or to Skred, or neither. We could actually just play a Grandmaster or something. I think it's better to kill this Mana Dork, though. I'm just gonna... We're in the very early game, so I think Skredding is fine. Who knows how many land drops I'm gonna hit? Like, for all I know, my opponent's playing the mono green aggro deck in Modern, and he's just gonna go second forest, play a 2-mana 3/3, and then we wouldn't be able to kill it with Skred. Maybe we don't get our second red for Anger of the Gods. Like, yeah. So now there's a Skred that's just gonna hang out in our graveyard. I think we're playing against elves. I think that's the only way this makes sense. I'm just going to pass now. Sorry about that noise. It has been taken care of. Alright. Yeah, now we're in this situation where we, like, killing a random elf doesn't actually stunt his growth very well. I think it's better to play towards Remand finding us a second red for the Anger of the Gods. And we also have some instant speed removal, either in just playing a Bolt or snapcasting back the Skred. We have options, for sure. Don't mind taking a few points of damage. The opponent only has 3 cards left in his hand. Yeah. I would love to Serum Visions here. Deal. I want both of these cards. Yep, just gonna pass. Do not mind taking a little bit of damage here, because the Soulfire Grandmaster should give us that back. Yep. He's gonna play something here. To untap his Nest Sentinel. Yeah, I'm actually going to remand it. Not because I want to remand an Elvish Visionary particularly, I just want to draw 2 cards deeper for my next turn. So this way, I'll draw the Swans, and then I can actually use the fetch land, if that's something that I want to do. I probably do. Like I said, he's got 3 cards in his hand. I think I'm just going to play Swans. I don't think he has many plays that can burn me for that. And then I can just untap in Anger. Like, even if he plays double Lord here, the Lords are only going to be 3 X's, or X3's rather. Well, both. My opponent laughed at my, I just saw this now. He laughed at my Skred when I only had a single snow-covered land in play. Target legendary creature. I think this gives something +1/+1. Yeah. The nice thing about Angering post Swans is that we can draw 3 cards from that too, draw into another red source. So if we really need to play a Bolt on top of the Anger to kill an Elf Lord, that's something we should be able to do here. He's just passing the turn. Harvest Pyre could be good. It's gonna Anger before I do anything else. Cool. That was awesome. Yeah, best actual removal spell ever. So we could Harvest Pyre and draw another 6. Or we could Serum Visions and Bolt. I think I'm just going to pass the turn. I think he's flooding out a little bit, but I think we would be fine even if he wasn't. This is like a dream matchup, it feels like. You got it, man. Collect some company. This is kind of cool. I'm not afraid of this card at all. Like, resolve your spell, man. Yep, you have a Lord. So we're just gonna get a basic snow covered mountain. Harvest Pyre our swans for six cards. Untap, play Soulfire Grandmaster. Burn away his board, smack him with a bird spirit. Oh, interesting that Swans is a spirit. I didn't know that. That means you could play Cavern on spirit and tap and use it to make Geist of St. Draft uncounterable and the Swans of Bryn Argoll uncounterable. And Geist of St. Draft is the type of card that I might want to play in this deck. Like, that doesn't sound bad to me. Shoom, 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 shoom. Oh, that's nice. I can just click the next card down. Well, this seems really hard to lose. Alright, I guess I'll... yeah, run this out. And I can't remember if I played a land or not, so I'm just gonna... no, I haven't. Cool. Yeah, I might as well just kill this too then. Whatever. Still have to discard. We're back up to 18. Yeah, Soulfire Grandmasters are pretty interesting way to stabilize. Great card with Scred. So if we're facing elves, what does that mean? Maybe we want paths? Definitely want these engineered explosives. You come in, probably you in. Remand's out. Call that good? That actually looks really good. Yeah, I like that a lot. This has to be our dream matchup. I can't imagine. Alright. Sand seems solid. Gets a deck full of creatures. Turn one, bolt your thing. Turn two, whatever. I could actually see just holding up Spell Snare, actually, on this turn two. You'll let him untap with his Mana Dork. If he plays, if he, like, uses this time to ramp into a Lord, then it's no big deal. But I'm pretty glad I get to Spell Snare this Spellskite. That's some flavor win. They're both like snatching spells. Oh, he's down to two cards. He must have mulled. He must have mulled really low. That's real unfortunate. Cool. Yeah, that these fetch lands can get basics is just really, really good. Set a stop on his draw step. Don't want to wait until his end of turn because there's a decent chance the best card in his hand costs 4 mana. Thragtusk, Beast Within. Oh my god. Yeah, we're just gonna take the Swag Father. Cycle that bad boy. So now he has Beast Within and some lands, I guess. Visionary, sure. Visionary was the card that I was thinking of when I held up Spell Snare a turn or two ago. This Vendilion Click seems really good. Seems really good here, right? That was, I'm not just saying that because that was a Caleb D edition. I'm saying that because it seems to fit the deck really, really well. I was having a lot of time pressuring the opponent if I didn't have a Swans. Like, if I had a Swans, like, I would just throw a Scred at it and very easily snowball that into a win. If I didn't have a Swans, I would just kind of... just kind of sit here with a pile of Screds in my hand. So yeah, I think I'm going to move it up to two clicks after this. Like, the deck is not very threat dense. Like, at all. Normal blue-white-red control gets to run Celestial Colonnade. So even when its few threats are answered, it can just start activating some 4/4s and getting in there. Ooh, I like you. He's just going to beast within it, but we are going to get some life back. Actually, yeah. Maybe he doesn't want a beast within it. If I was him, I wouldn't want me untapping with it either, though. Dragonlord Ojutai, where have you been all my life? What? Okay. I have something special in mind. Sure. Mountain or island? I guess island, so we can cast Cryptic if we draw it. Overcommitting, name of the game. Opponent plays a spare Nykthos, just in case. Okay. Alright, on to the next round.